Welcome back to a very special coffee tech break today, because I wanted to take you through a year review of 2021. There's a lot of exciting things that happened: new products, new features, new applications. But first, let's take a step back and take a cup of coffee. Because I want to thank the community in this final moments of 2021. I want to thank the community for all the likes that you've given to me and the comments, sharing with me all those coffee tech breaks, which is really appreciated. At the end, I think more than 2,000 likes during the year. I created more than 100 videos, so I guess every time when you are enthusiastic, I become enthusiastic. So I think that is really, really positive. Also, in the new year, I'm ready to get started again. Of course, I will take some time the next couple of weeks with family also. Take a step back. And just take some time with the family, relax a little bit, and reload. Get some new energies, get some new ideas, etc. There's a lot of exciting things expected for 2022. So I'm already excited to get started. But it's a good moment to get some time for yourself also. Relax a little bit. As usual, always subscribe to my channel, so you will get an alert as soon as I bring out videos in the new year. Today it is a sort of special edition, because as I said, so many things have happened, and I just want to bring you and show you those highlights. So I will, as usual, jump in my computer and walk you through all those great highlights today. I won't jump out of it to do some hands-on because it's just a walkthrough, but I just wanted to show you all those great things that that has happened. Hopefully you appreciate it and you will enjoy it. Let's jump in my computer now and show you 2021 in a review. Now, as usual, and probably the last time for this year, just take a cup of coffee, sit back, just relax. And I will walk you through this presentation, which is in a sort of Christmas mood, as we are all just before Christmas time. Year review 2021. As I said, a lot of things has happened during the last year. And especially I want to thank also all those application providers, like Teams, Starleaf, RingCentral, GoToRoom, LogMeIn, Zoom, Dialpad, and BlueJeans, all those application providers who spent quite some time in building those applications for the Studio X and G7500 series, which at the end made it very successful in 2021. And also, I'm really looking forward to 2022, as I see what already happened during this year. So, first off, I want to take a step back, you know, 2021, and maybe even go back to 2020, as there was quite some challenge where the whole world was turned around and started to use video all of a sudden. Not everybody had the luxury to have a specific meeting where they can do video, jump into those special rooms. In the office, you had to have space between the participants in those rooms. Also very, very important, but also that became a challenge for cameras and doing video conferencing in those larger rooms. At home, and to make sure you sit in the right place, you sit at the right spot in front of the camera. There was a lot of things going on to make that happen and get that laptop at the same height as your as you are sitting behind the desk. The children at home and this new way of working is also a challenge with all the noise around you at home. And normally in the office, you have that private space where you can sit, but at home, It could be a combination where you are sitting and working with your family and with your children. Now, one thing that stands out, and that is, I think, also for me, is unplugging after work, because normally you are at the office, you just leave the office, you jump in your car, you drive home, or you go with the public transport, and you can sort of leave work behind you. But when you are at home, the problem is you're not really leaving the office. So unplugging, as you see also coming out of those reports, was really, really a challenge. And how do I do that? I have the luxury that I have here, my own space, and also where I can do my my videos. But usually, at the end of the day, I just shut down everything. I walk out of this room and I sort of give myself a feeling that I'm walking out of the office. And this is, I think, very important for yourself and your mind, to make sure you try to create sort of difference between your office and your private life. Also, just beneath that is the loneliness, which I can also imagine, because working at home, missing your colleagues and your friends is, I think, really a thing. So at the end, probably it will be something in between the next couple of years. I'm gonna work at least some time in the office, at least some time at home. This is how I would absolutely see this for. But it's good to take the step back, what we have seen the last year when you look at all those challenges. On the other end, for the video and UC providers, it was enormously. Video went sky high the last year. As you look at all those platforms, a lot of people jump to video and start using that at home. But of course, when you sit at home, you also need to have the right devices and make sure you got the right webcam, you got the right headset or a speakerphone. That's very important. So it was really a challenge last couple of years to find your way at home and get those right devices. A lot of options came to life in 2021. And so we got those webcams, a P5, as you see here. We got the P15 out there, which is that standalone bar for your executive office or for your home office. Really nice, everything built in. The Sync family, really popular speaker. So not everybody can sit the whole day with the headset. And then the Sync family is really easy to jump in where needed, where you can just sit hands-free, use it with your laptop, use it with your phone, and you can have those hands-free calls. Really, really nice. And also for Trio, for the conference rooms, to make sure that the people have the right distance in the rooms. Trio is enormous for his microphone range, just like the Sync 60. And so there was a lot of interest also in that area, but also in executive offices, it can make sense. For the headset, it was crazy. I guess all the headsets that were there were going out massively. But what we see in 2021, which probably will go into 2022, is people will look for noise-canceling headsets. And as you see with those new headsets, which came out recently, the Voyager Focus 2, the 4320, where you got the noise canceling. So also not noise canceling only for your ears, but also when you talk to the other side through that microphone. So there is some additional microphones on the outside where it actually filters also sounds around you to the other end. So it's a really a sort of hybrid ANC headset. All those new technologies were coming out very, very quickly. Not to forget the P21. It is a really interesting one because it gives you that additional light in the room, because not everybody has that that separate space or their own space or the correct lighting. And the P21 is that all-in-one speaker, camera, mic, but also screen. So you just hook this guy up to your laptop and you can just work completely from this device. So your UC client, which can be Zoom, Teams or any other video clientele, you use that on your laptop, and you can use the P21, which also has that additional lightnings here on the side. Also, that was an interesting one in 2021, where you've seen a lot of gain and getting those additional lightnings in those rooms. The hybrid worker. Now, the hybrid worker, because people are sitting in the office and at home, but also don't forget PolyLens. So PolyLens is that cloud-based service. So if all those devices are going home or in the office, you want to make sure that these are up to date with the latest and greatest software, have those new functionalities available. So there was Lens, and Lens, you can use that standalone on your laptop. So then you can update for all of those devices, make sure they are at the right firmware, or you can push it out also from the PolyLens side to make sure those devices are there. And also you can set policies, etc. But that was also an interesting time in 2021. And I see that only growing in 2022. What was happening more? And when we look at the office, a lot of things were happening there. Looking at camera options. So we got the X70 out there for those bigger rooms. So really the need for those additional camera functionality, which can go deeper in that room and find those participants. Eagle Eye Director 2 was massively popular in 2021, especially because of that tracking functionality in those bigger rooms. There's a lot of excitement there. And we see now the excitement also coming for the X70 and the E70, really two brand new cameras, which got that dual lens functionality and also have the ability to go further into that into those rooms. Now, not to forget Studio USB. Studio USB, as you see here, using it with a barcode system in the room, so just hands-free, and bring your own meeting. So bring in that dongle, put it in the laptop, and share camera, speaker, mic, and screen from your laptop very easily. So also, it was a very big bundle, which I've seen a lot. 2022, I will also do some videos on the Barco devices, the ClickShare devices, and to have the ability to show you how you can use that, as it is very, very easy. Also in the healthcare, we've seen a lot of usage with Studio USB. Studio USB, massively popular speaker bar in 2021. I think, especially because of the flexibility, because you can just hook it up to your laptop and just use it with any video client and very quickly. And in the future, if you're moving to a Teams room or to a Zoom room, you can easily reuse that speaker bar, as it is also certified for those platforms. So very, very flexible. Now, what more was going on? PIX 30. Also very popular for those smaller rooms where you can sit with one, two, or three people. The X50, the G7500, also really interesting for those integrations. And I will show you a bit later about all those flexibility also with third-party DSPs. And one that stood out and ended in 2021 is the X70. So I expect a lot of developments for those larger rooms with the X70, the dual lens camera inside where they can create all sort of production rooms for those meeting rooms. Gonna be a really exciting, exciting time. The hybrid worker. Now, other things that we've seen is the Sync family. So I created some videos on these recently, as these are also very, very popular. Just having them in your home office, executive office, or now moving into that meeting room, certified for Zoom, certified for Teams. And you can actually just use it with any video platform and just hook it up to the laptop, and you have the ability to use it. Also in 2021, we opened up the ability for the 40 and the 60 to daisy chain. So you can even bring it further into the room and hook it up like sort of the primary. You hook that through USB up to your Teams room system, and the secondary can just wirelessly connect to that primary. So there's a lot of things which were happening to make life for that hybrid worker very, very easy. Now, let me walk through those features, just some highlights. I know I cannot do this whole year in a video. That will probably take me quite some coffees. So I will do the highlights today as the sort of Christmas end of year edition to walk them through, as some great things happened in the Studio X and G7500. First off, the out-of-box experience. That was massively improved during this year. So you can now, out of the box, on your factory reset, it will ask you, are you on a network? If you're not on the network or the network is not connected, you're able to connect it to the Wi-Fi. So we got Zoom and Teams who support the Wi-Fi. So you can actually use it on a trolley just with the power and just move it around easy in combination with a touchscreen, as Teams support that, Zoom supports that. So you're able to bring it around very easily and work with a touchscreen on a trolley with X30, X50 on it. I think very flexible. So out-of-box experience was massively improved in 2021. Now, this is, I think, a really nice one. The device mode idle timeout. It's just, maybe it's just a small thing, but it can be really helpful. So what's happened there, all of the providers, including Teams has the device mode now. So that means as soon as you plug in that USB cable, it will jump into the device mode. Now, the scenario is when the user plugs it out and you want to jump back to the native application. And here you can set the timeout. When do you want to move back to that application? Here you have the ability to configure that. And that means for Zoom or for Teams, for any of those applications, you're able to set that timeout. I think a really, really nice one. Also, what's happening in 2021 were the extra controls were introduced. So you can do now on the TCA some additional room control. Really, really nice. In this combination, you can set lighting, a camera, displays on, etc. As you can see as a sample here, you can configure now all those things. We got those controls available. So I see this really as a new journey where you can also have additional controls in the rooms with your TC8, your Studio X and G7500. Digital signage. I think this is also a very nice one because those rooms are sometimes just not used, or the screen estate is not used. And what you hear a lot is that people walk into the room and they don't know exactly what to do. So what you can do with digital signage is you can play a sort of instruction video or create a sort of instruction map for that user who walks into that room, sees that digital signage, which can be a rolling presentation or a video, etc. And you can point the user to the TCA to have the ability to use the device. But also company information like birthdays, sales statistics, etc. Something you want to share with the community. It's always available. So I'm really pleased that we're able to use that now on the Studio X and G7500. So you can configure that. You can set configurable timer, just like with the idle timeout, and you have the ability to change it to that app space, PowerPoint or video. And as soon as somebody clicks on the TC8, what will happen? It will jump out, and you will have the ability to use the device in that native application. Also, this works with Teams. Zoom has their own specific digital signage provider, so that's something you configure in Zoom. But most of the other providers say you can use the digital signage when it goes into that screen saver mode. What was also introduced in 2021 was the provider switch. Yes, so it was in the past that you had to do a factory, or you had a factory reset there, so your account reset, etc. That messed up all the times a lot of things. So now provider switch is only a reboot. So you reboot and then it will be available in and joining into another application. So this actually is very flexible. So in case you need for a day, you need it in Zoom, and you have the ability to change that through the web UI of the Studio XR G3500. You can use Lens, and in the latest release, what you probably have seen, you can also now use the APIs. So in case you got a Crestron, AMX, or any other controller, the Telnet commands are there now, and so you're able to change it to those different providers. I think really flexible. So I expect in 2022 also that integrators will be able to use this command. And for example, before you join the room, you have a sort of menu where you even can select the provider you want to use. So I think this is a really nice feature which will be enhancing more and more. Third-party USB cameras. Yes, so you can connect cameras from our different providers. So for example, the IoGeni, this is a converter which is converting HDMI to USB. Because most of the times with the Studio X, when you use the HDMI input, you cannot use it for content anymore. So with the InoGeni, what you can do is you can convert the HDMI from a professional camera, convert it to USB, and then you connect that USB cable into the Studio X or G3500. So you can really create that additional camera option here with those devices. And always check the release notes, because I know Zoom supports multiple cameras, for example. Teams doesn't do multiple cameras yet. So always check the release notes, because this is important. If you're going to use those different functionalities, it will always depend on the application if it's able to use it. Other cameras which you're able to connect to, as maybe from a different room view or something, is the Vagio, the Huddly, or a Logitech Rally. You can all hook these up to G3500, X50, or X70. And you could easily change that room view from different angles if needed. So this is also became available in 2021. A really nice and flexible option if you got one of those cameras lying around in your office. Third-party DSP integration. This was also introduced in 2021. So yes, you can use the controls from an Extron or a Crestron, but also you can use the DSP integration from Biamp, Shure, or QSC, and integrate that with the Studio X series. Probably usually from the X50, X70, or G3500. Those devices will all have that flexibility. As you can see, really, really some things happened in 2021. Incredible. Now, what about cable extensions? I think there's some really nice options out there, and I shared also one of my videos, the options with sound control technologies. So if you need to extend it, for example, for the E70 over Cat5, E-Cat6, you got those custom options available. So I shared this in one of my videos, which are easy to find back, where I'm talking through all those different options. They got a very nice website, which got all those very nice data sheets, you're able to hook up and how you're able to hook up those devices, etc. So if you need to extend it, and also, as you can see here, for the device mode for the X30 and X50, or device mode for the G7500, you got all those options laid out here for those cable extensions. It's one of my videos, so I would just recommend to check that out. One of the items which was, I think, somewhere at the beginning of 2021 is the inverted options. So yes, you can invert mount an X30. So I think that's very good to know. So as you see here, if you want to put it under the screen, I can imagine you want to invert mount it, because then the cables will be hidden behind the screen, because these will all move up. And there's an option in the web UI to set the invert mounting. And also there's a package. So you have another front plate where the logo is correctly located there. So it will be turned around. So there is a package for this where you're able to do that. These were just some highlights about Studio X and G3500. As I said, I would really recommend if you want to dive deeper in those highlights, just check back into my videos. Applications. Also specifically to all those applications, a lot of things has happened. And again, I'm just picking out those highlights of those different applications. And the first one I want to start with is Zoom. As a lot of things changed during the last year, and they did quite some investment in that that application for Studio X and G7500. Where can you find Zoom? Well, you can find it now in any room. So Zoom actually also has now multi-cell decked phones, which you can use throughout the office. Really nice, and integrates with Zoom Phone. We got the ability for medium rooms with the X30 and X50. Headsets. We got certified headsets in combination with Zoom with noise cancelling. Large rooms, massively. So the X70 is already up and running, fully operation, certified with Zoom. So you can use that in your large room. G7500 with the E70 is supported. Now, and you can integrate it with Biome, Shure, QSC, and all those DSP providers to create those different rooms. For the home office, you can also use all those devices we talked earlier, so the Sync family, the P5 as webcam, the P15, P21, all the headsets that we have. So also you can fully functional and have that good audio and video also at home. In the conference room for voice only, also a possibility, and just use that Trio as a conference phone. But also you can use the Trio as a remote and as a speaker and mic in combination with the X30, X50 and G3500. The Trio has that great interface which you can use. And also the phones. A lot of things happened. So we even got native app running on CCX, which we'll show you a bit later. Probably I will do some videos in 2021 to show you that brand new user experience with Zoom. And actually that CCX interface with that native Zoom app will be across the board. So we'll also will come to the TCA, but I will show you that a bit later. And we got the P21 in the office for your hurdle spaces, similar for your X30 and X50. Now, talk you through some highlights of some features which are available in Zoom. I think incredible. And also let me take you through some practical things which I've done in 2021 to combine those features. So what I did, for example, is I brought X70 because a customer wanted to see that in their largest rooms and do a tryout. So what I did is I hooked up the X70 in Zoom. I hooked it up through my phone. I used my phone as a 3G and set it up as a hotspot. And I used my phone also as a remote control for the X70. So I was able to join the meeting very easily with the X70 and be able to dial out and show the X70 to the customer. Let them hear the audio, see the tracking, see the camera quality. And yes, customer was really happy as they bought 10 of them like 2 days later. So it was a really successful demonstration. So you can actually really easily demonstrate that to customer with that Wi-Fi support. And also the E70 is officially supported with the G7500. So you can use also that combination. Direct cast join, what we've seen in 2021. In a lab feature, so you can join from the Zoom side. So in the native Zoom, you can join in Teams very easily, just as a guest. So it will use a sort of Chromium interface. You have to at least the ability to join those meetings. Really, really nice. Multi-camera support. This was one which I thought was also really interesting, because I've seen several integrators building all sort of scenarios, as you can see here, with cameras in classrooms or in meeting rooms with that room shot. So you can easily switch between those rooms on the touch panel. Also, that Wi-Fi support gave the option for trolleys. Also very nice. And you could even use a remote control. So in case you don't want to have the TC8. So the TC8, of course, requires that PoE. And if you work with a trolley, it might be easier to use a touchscreen on that trolley or use a separate remote. It is a Bluetooth remote, but you have the ability to at least click on a meeting, join a meeting, or mute, etc. So many things happened. Really excited. Virtual background in your meeting rooms was also enabled. We got Trio, which went through quite some application iterations. So you can attach now two Trios in the latest version. That's officially certified, and three TC8s. So always look in the release note, but you can attach multiple TC8s, multiple Trios in your environment. This was like just some highlights of 2021 and some scenarios. In the latest version, we also had Smart Gallery and Multiview enabled for the E70, G7500, and also now for the X70. Yes, so you can actually pick out those participants in the room using a Smart Gallery. And they call it now Multiview, so you see it also in the touch panel as named as Multiview, but it grabs out that digital image, it grabs out the participants in the room and puts it in its own gallery in your Zoom application. Really nice. If you haven't played around with that, you can also check out one of my other videos, so I will put a link there so you're able to check that out. It's still called Smart Gallery in that video, but as I said, the official naming now, I think, is Multiview, but it's similar functionality. More has happened in 2021 with the Zoom. We also had a function in there. This is the automatic device mode, as similar as we have now with Teams. So you just hook up that USB cable, and you're able to use your the camera, speaker, and mic in Studio X, or the cameras attached to and speakers attached to G7500, reuse that with your laptop. So you could use any video client you have. I think this is something that's really important, that hybrid setup, so you can use the system natively in Zoom or Teams or anything, but always have the ability with your laptop to join any other meetings if you want that. So automatic device mode is available, and it will prompt you. So as soon as you hook up your laptop, the TC8 will automatically prompt you if you want to do device mode. If you don't want that, you can always cancel that. Similar with the Trio C60, it will also nicely prompt you as soon as you hook up your USB cable in your laptop. It will ask you if you want to use the device mode. Now, when you are in the device mode, as you can see here, you can have the mute, you can have camera control, you have volume control, etc. So this will be available as soon as you jump into the device mode. Now, what more happened in 2021? So we also introduced the Zoom phone appliance. So we already had a lot of SIP devices integrated with Zoom, also Rove, which we integrated in 2021 using SIP and the CCX range. But what we introduced, really nice, is the native application. So this is really the Zoom application natively running on the CCX range, and specifically on the 600 and the 700. So with the 600, you can get the additional camera, the Eagle Eye Mini. And with the 700, you got that built-in camera. So it has that really nice interface, Zoom look and feel. And this is the same interface which you will also get on the TC8. Really nice, simple for a user, just easily to start meetings. So you got your video, send to receive, You can even receive content on these phones. You can do whiteboarding. Probably in 2022, look out for a video also on this side, because I wanted to take you through all the options available with the Zoom phone appliance. Really, really powerful. Now, as I said, there's also some new things in this presentation which I haven't showed you yet, and probably I will do a full review in the new year. But we have a new version which came out this week, that is the Zoom app version 5.9. So actually, you got that new interface, which I showed you a bit earlier on the CCX phones. We got exact that same interface. We got that now on the TC8. Really, really nice. Very simple and slick. So Zoom has now across the board and CCX, and on the rooms, they got exactly the same interface. So as a user, that feels very familiar. Now, if you're using your phone or you walk into a meeting room, everywhere you have that same look and feel, which I think is really powerful. Now, how can you upgrade that? Just very quickly, just go to that Zoom admin portal, and here you go in, and there you can check upgrade your Zoom rooms, so as well as your controller, your TC8, as your X3650 or G7500. And here you can upgrade that to that 5.9 release, which is available now since this week. Now, I will probably do more deep dives into this in 2022, but I just want to show you the highlights now of 2021, as there's so many things to talk about. As I said, I'm trying to keep it within a couple of coffees. So another application which also got quite some new features and benefits is the Teams application. Now, Teams is also used throughout home and office everywhere. So you got that medium-sized room, you got that open offices for headsets, large rooms, which you got the flexibility with MTR for Windows, and use that in combination with the E70. We got the Sync 60 and Sync 40 certified for Teams, and you can use any of those integration, those third-party DSPs in combination with the MTR for Windows. Also at home, you got a full portfolio available, hurdle spaces with your devices, desk phones, conference phones, so you can run Trio C60, you can natively run the Teams application there and should just use it as a voice device if you want. So a lot of things became available in 2021. Really nice. If you look at the features that were becoming available in 2021, I think huge. A lot of things happened, as you can see right here. We got 1080p in resolution, just some highlights. We got the dual screen support for the X50. We got new meeting layouts, there's that together mode, that large mode. We got recording, we got whiteboarding. So you got that enhanced whiteboarding in the X30, X50, and also in the G7500, which is in a sort of Teams preview mode. And we got this year the HDMI ingest in device mode, which I'll show you a bit more about that in the next slide. But there's so many things happened. Just as I said, that these are just a couple of highlights. Device mode, as I said and showed you in my 3.9 video, we have that available now. Really nice. So you can use your HDMI from your laptop and have the ability now to share your presentation just locally, but also in the Teams meeting, of course. You got these two scenarios. And also, if you want to use specific application on your laptop, you can use the USB cable on your laptop and make sure you can join those meetings, at least from your laptop. But you got the ability there. Now, let me take you specifically through that HDMI sharing and device mode, because I got some questions about that, specifically about the audio. So this scenario, when you walk into the room and you want to share something, specifically on that. So you got that presentation here on your laptop and you want to put that on the screen. Very easily put in the HDMI cable and you're able to put it on the screen. Now, important, as I said, that is video only. Now, if you want to share some multimedia in that room, I recommend to use device mode. So you put in that USB cable in the laptop, and that means it will jump to device mode. So for speaker functionality, you can use the USB cable. Again, you put in your HDMI cable, and for that video you want to show. And on the other end, you can use here the USB cable, which you have the availability to share your audio here also to your X30. X50 or a G7500. I think really, really flexible. So I got some questions about that using the audio. So there is always a way to share your multimedia or your video in that room. Now, the other option to enable the device mode was through the TC8, which I'm also showing in that earlier video with the 3.9. update. Now, further, be aware of the G7500 that is now available with Teams and the sort of preview mode, so you can test and play around with it. But be aware, only the HDCI cameras, so Ego Director 2, the Producer, the Cube using the HDCI, and you've got the Ego Eye 4 4x zoom or Ego Eye 4 12x zoom, and you can use all those cameras. Or reuse your cameras from your Visio Pro or your Group Series, reuse that with the G7500. Really, really nice. And expect, of course, in 2022, we'll also get the E70 at the end running on the G7500. But just stay tuned on my channel and I will keep you updated on that. Now, what more happened? MTR for Windows. So we have the availability of the icon Raven, which was officially tested. As we got questions around, besides using that USB cable, that standard fiber USB cable with 10 meters, 25, 40 meters, sometimes not easy to integrate in that room. So in 2021, we also introduced and supported the Icon Raven 3104. So I created also a video on that, which you might want to review and to look at all those details. But it's supported with all those packages, those team packages, which we have now. Teams phones. Also, a lot of development has been going on. The whole interface got a refresh. There's a lot of features and functionalities like iMotions, which became available in the phones. You can use it with the CCX 400, 500, and 600. I would just say, get one of those phones, put it into the native Teams, and play around with that. Now, moving back to the application. So, as I said, so many nice things happened in 2021 and investment of those video application providers. For example, Starleaf, also massive investment in the application. So supporting dual screen on the X50, supporting multiple cameras, wireless content sharing, the HD resolution, HID supported for the headset to use in combination with their PC application. So really good to see. And also, which one is really nice, is the fallback scenario. So if you're using Studio X or a G7500 in Teams or Zoom, it's fine. But you can then use Starleaf as a fallback scenario. So in case something is not functioning on that side, you can change Studio X, but also change your meetings and replace them with a Starleaf meeting as a fallback scenario. Really nice. They enhanced that in the latest release. So I would really recommend to check that out on the Starleaf website. It's a fallback scenario where you always have at least something available, because video becomes more and more critical in the market and also for your meeting rooms. So in case there is a failure on any of your current platform you're using, you can always fall back to Starleaf with that scenario. So great to see that, and check that out on their website. Let's go back to the application. As I said, otherwise it will take me more than two coffees at the end. Let's look at GoToRoom. From LogMeIn, as these guys also did, I think, tremendous job on the application and the development on it, supporting now X70, E70 with G7500. As you can see, a very nice and simple user interface. And also here the availability to integrate it with your calendaring, create custom wallpapers, join third-party meetings where you will be able to use the device mode functionality. Really nice. So they got it all integrated. Really nice. I would say in 2022, you probably will see me creating some new videos because these guys all did a tremendous job and I will probably catch up with some new videos on that. What's more, so we have also Ring Central. These guys also worked massively on the application and supporting now X70, supporting the G7500 with the E70, also the user interface, really, really nice. So Ring Central, they even have some white label functionality here, so they can even customize application and build it in a sort of white label for all those different providers. They did a lot of work in 2021, so I expect quite some new things in 2022. And again, I will try to do some new videos in 2022 to show you and walk you through all those new interfaces. Let's get back to those applications now. What more has happened? So BlueJeans came out of the gate, is now public available. Again, I would just recommend to try that out. You can use it now. It's in the drop-down menu now as a available, public available application. So you probably need some licenses from BlueJeans. So I would say just check it out and also let me know your experience. And again, I will probably also try to do an unboxing and a user experience video in 2022. What more do we have looking at the application? The last one, Dialpad. Dialpad is now also available on the Studio X, X30 and X50. Not yet on G7500 or an X70. Probably that will come during the next year. Dialpad is also a big one in the market, growing very fast in the cloud communication market. They do talk, messaging, meetings, contact center, very big in the US. So we also have that application available now on that Studio X series. Now, as you can see, I think we really massively had some great highlights here for 2021. Really something to celebrate with each other as a great, great win. I'm already looking forward to 2022 and looking at what 2021 already brought us when you see the development and the innovation. We learned a lot, I think, through 2021, also from the meeting rooms, the usage, at home office, the hybrid user, how they're gonna use all the equipment, etc. So we learned a lot, and probably this will fine-tune everything and make everything ready for 2022 and the next couple of years to make it as easy as possible for that hybrid user in that meeting room or in the home office. Now to wrap up this video, and for the first time, I don't have a coffee. I have now my champagne just to bring a toast and thank everybody. So I wanted to wish everybody a Merry Christmas and Happy New Year. Stay safe and healthy also in 2022. I'm already looking forward to 2022, as I will probably see, as you've seen in 2021, we'll probably see a lot of innovation and also in 2022. I'm looking forward to see you again. Don't forget to subscribe to my channel, so I will give you a sign when new videos pop up. And for now, cheers, and looking forward to see you back in 2022.